All right, so welcome back to another day. We're going to be doing arms and abs today. So the way I do arms is I'll superset triceps with biceps. So we'll start off with tricep dips just off the end of the bench and go straight into a set of straight bar curls. And then once we're done with that, we'll head into tricep pushdowns and then straight into dumbbell curls. And then finally, we'll do some overhead tricep extensions and easy bar curls, and then end the abs off that. Let's get to it.
We'll be right back.
another important thing to remember whenever you're doing any kind of exercise really is the last rep of every set. I have always, in the past, I have had a tendency to get the rep number 10. You know, you contract the, you tend to count your number to the top of the contraction. And then you forget about the negative half in that last rep. Slow that down. If you can get, whenever you get to the top of the contraction, instead of just letting the weight go, lower it. You're getting, it's only an extra half a rep, but those half reps add up over time. So they do. And if they add up over time, then this is a time game essentially. The more consistently you can hit everything over a number of months, weeks, months, years, etc., all those little half reps eventually will add up. So they will. So that's something to keep in mind. All right, so we're going to move on now to the tricep pushdowns and dumbbell curls. So we are. So let's get to it. We'll be right back.
out of pretty much any other exercise other than seated rows. From my back, pump in my back from seated rows is crazy too, but biceps is right there with it, like. So for any of you wondering why I superset triceps with biceps in my workouts, rather than using supersets in a more traditional sort of intensifier fashion, is because your biceps and your triceps, they're quite small muscle groups that get worked during other exercises. Any pressing exercises or pulling exercises will use the biceps and triceps as an ancillary muscle. So whenever you're doing them, you have a dedicated day for to do them on their own, where you're not doing them with another body part. I like to superset them in order to make it more cardiovascularly intense, so it gets my heart rate up more if I do biceps and triceps one after the other. I'm using it more as an intensifier for cardiovascular purposes rather than, cardiovascular, just to elevate my heart rate more than it would otherwise be elevated if it was just to do a bicep exercise and then have a rest until the next set. So just in case you were wondering, that's why I... All right. Now we're going to move on to the last of the arm exercises. Overhead, tricep extensions, and easy bar curls. All right, so I just want to talk to you a second about what is probably the most underrated plate in any gym. And it's not the big 20 kilos or 45 pound plates. It's the fractional weight plates. Because here's the thing, after you've been training a while, you're not going to be able to put a 5 kilo plate on every lift. So you're not, especially for smaller muscle groups like arms. But see, a little half kilo one, is how you progress. So think of those as progression plates.
See you.
Right, that's it for arms. We'll go on to abs. So we'll do some cable twists first. That's cable twists done. So we'll go on now to leg raises off the bench.
Do you think I'm crazy? I've done all this before.
That's land leg raises done. We're going to the last exercise of today, which is going to be decline crunches or sit-ups. Yeah, whatever you call them. Fuck it. Alright, that's abs finished. That's a complete week now. We'll get set up again for legs, which next week's the winter festival week. So I'm not sure if I'm going to do a deload week that week or if maybe do legs on Sunday. Don't know. We'll see how I feel. Anyway, if I don't train next week, or if I only do some pissy because of the holiday, then I'll not start uploading again until the week after. So there may be a bit of a break, but we'll see. We'll try and keep something coming. So well, and in the meantime, if you've enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you've not enjoyed the video, go ahead and give it a dislike. Comment, subscribe, do all the normal YouTuber things, because that algorithm, it's growing and it needs the food to grow, and its food is the comments, the likes, the subscribes, all that good stuff. Anyway, I'll see you next time, and take it easy.